look up and down.
Everything seems okay there. Do you have any headaches?
No.
Have any worries?
What do you mean, worries?
Well, how do you get on with your family?
Okay.
How about school?
Good.
What about nightmares?
So that's it. I thought this was just a checkup.
This is just a checkup, and you're a very healthy young fella. But your father's worried about those nightmares.
He's only worried because I yell a bit in my sleep and wake him up. Well, anyway, they're just dreams. Everyone dreams, don't they?
Yes. Do you remember what they're about?
No. Sorry.
Any other problems?
Yeah. Well, my father doesn't understand me. Can I go now?
I guess so.
Careful not to crush this. You might have to run an iron over it in the morning.
All right, then. Okay, thank you. Mm. And I'll see you after the wedding.
Right. Have a good time.
Yes.
And tell Lorraine I'm sure she'll be a beautiful bride.
Yes, she will, won't she? This is a lucky man. See you later.
Bye.
Anyway, I don't know why she's going on about it. There's not going to be any mess, eh?
Yeah, better get her a ring. Probably won't get much of a chance once the guys turn up.
Okay.
Church.
Yeah.
Any last minute message for Lorraine?
No, I'm just about to ring her.
Oh, good idea. Listen, don't drink too much tonight.
Don't worry.
Good. Good eye. Scott, hold that, will you?
Hey, Danny, tell Shane to get a move on, will you?
Oh, yeah, okay.
Hello?
Is that Daphne? Hi, my name's Ramsey, Shane Ramsey.
Yes, Mr. Ramsey?
We're having a bucks party for a mate tonight. I was wondering if you'd be available.
What do you want done?
Oh, just a bit of dancing, you know.
Well, make sure you eat it. Short notice. I've got another booking just before midnight.
Oh, that's fine. Any time after midnight's okay.
Paul's calling for you, Shane.
I'll give you the address.
Did you see a doctor?
24 yeah. Ramsey Street.
Uh-huh. Great. Great. Bye.
What did he say? He said I'm having nightmares. Dad didn't have to go telling him that.
Come on, Danny. You won't tell us what's wrong with you. Look, what else can we do?
Mum, I keep telling you, there's nothing wrong with me.
Danny, please.
Well, I'm off then. See you tomorrow.
I still think you should find time to have a decent meal.
You just don't understand, do you? A bucks party takes a lot of organisation. It's got to be something old Desi will remember for the rest of his married life.
Oh, yes, but why in this street? You know what your father's like about noise?
We'll be so quiet, Mum. He won't even know we're in there. I promise.
I want you both to drink this and get straight into bed.
No chatting on till midnight.
Don't worry, Mrs. Kingham. I'll make sure she gets to bed.
How's Daddy?
Still sulking. Oh, well, you know, Lorraine is his only daughter.
Yes. Never mind. He'll get used to her being married. Good night, Julie.
Good night, Mrs. Kingham.
Sleep well, darling.
Good night, Mum.
Tomorrow is meant to be the happiest day of your life, remember?
Well, I just wish Daddy liked him, that's all.
But the thing is that you love him. That's all that matters. You know, Lorraine, I really admire you. Nothing your father can say is going to change your mind. You love Des. And look, so many girls get married, you know, and they're not really sure. But then look at us. When I was going out with Des, you know, I just knew. I just knew he was not right for me. And then you started the bank and you just knew.
Why wasn't he right for you?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know. Well, he isn't really a spunk, is he? I mean, you know, he's nice. He's ordinary. He'll make a great father, for sure. He's a little bit set in his ways, and I suppose that's a good thing. Although
what?
Lorraine, look what we're both doing. We're picking on poor old Des to pieces the night before the wedding. No. You love him. I mean, he's one of my best friends. You're going to be our neighbours and we're going to live happily ever after.
Yeah. Daddy hates him, you know.
I know. Oh, well, but you know, he isn't the one that has to love, honour and obey him, is he? You know, Lorraine, I just hope that when I get married, that I love my guy as much as you must love Des.
Yeah. Still engaged.
Please, Lorraine, it's 2 o'clock in the morning.
I just want to talk to him, that's all.
Yes, all right. Well, you can talk to him later. Look, I know exactly what he's done. He's taken the phone off the hook so he can have a really good sleep.
Scream
what
happened? Down again, that's what.
What do you mean? Scream.
Oh, get back to sleep, will you? And shut up, for Pete's sake. It's
Max.
2 in the flaming morning.
Shh. It's all right, Daddy. It's fine. It's all right. What's all that music?
That Bugs party.
A terrible dream.
You sure did. Your father was just about to break up the party, and he started to yell again.
Why doesn't he leave them alone? It's their party.
Yes, but they could have turned it down after midnight. Just getting worse. Remember what you were dreaming about?
No, I can't.
Flaming Bucks parties. It's Max. Now listen, what are you going to do about them bloody neighbours of yours?
Oh, come on, mate. It's the poor guy's last night of freedom. I'll pack it in soon.
Oh, they'll pack it in all right. If you don't tell them to belt up, I'll be in there myself.
Leave it to me, mate.
What's a girl doing in there?
Probably a stripper. They usually have strippers at dudes like that.
That sounds like your son again. I hope he doesn't remember that tomorrow. Does the stripper really leap out of the cake?
Only in Hollywood.
How was Max?
He's fine. I told him I'd take care of it. But if they don't stop soon, he'll be over there like a wild bull.
I can't sleep.
Oh. I know, darling. Come on. It'll be over soon.
I have pulled telling those dirty jokes again, Grandma.
Oh, they're really not dirty, just silly.
Grandma, what are you doing?
More to the point, what are you?
Dad, Lucy.
You haven't been next door, have you?
No, I haven't.
I thought you were in bed. Where have you been?
Just out. You're not up because of me, are you?
No, no one can sleep because of all that racket.
The Ramsey's lights are on as well.
Yeah, we know.
Yeah, well, good night.
Hold it. You were supposed to be in by midnight. Where have you been?
I'll get it. Hello?
Who's that?
It's Scott.
Put your old man on.
Talk to you in the morning. Yes, Max.
What happened?
Give me another 15 minutes, mate.
Like hell I will. Some of us have got to work in the morning, remember?
Tomorrow's Saturday, Max.
Cripes! Even the flaming dogs are at it now. Okay. I'll stop it myself.
Max, sometimes I'm very grateful to Max Ramsey and that temper of his.
I feel sorry for young Des. He did ask us if we'd mind him having a party.
Yes, but he did say that it'd be over by 1 o'clock. And from the sound of it, they could still be there when it comes time to go to the church.
Right.
Good night, my dear.
Good night. Oh, no.
I believe the best man lives here.
Like that? Great party.
Morning, Mr. Ramsey.
Oh, g'day, Scott. Hey, what are you two doing here?
Going for a swim. Where's Shane?
He's getting changed. Like an old woman this morning. Flaming party's going to all hours. Won't do his training much good, you know.
Hey, Scott.
Oh, here you are at last.
Where's the girls?
What girls?
They've both come here to chat up a couple of girls from school. You don't think they'd just come to watch me train, do you?
Oh, you're going to train, are you?
Sorry.
Try and get that pike fixed first, OK?
What's the matter with you anyway?
What do you mean?
You sick or something?
No.
Look, he's ready.
Take your time now.
Shane!
Yeah?
Be careful, okay?
Look, what are you?
Sorry.
That was better, eh?
I'm going home.
Paul, it's 8 o'clock.
Yeah, thanks, Dad. I'm up.
Bet he's suffering.
What about Des? There's still no sign of life next door.
Thanks, Farwell. Paul's the best man. The groom's his responsibility. I can just see the two of them holding each other up at the wedding, can't you? Speak of the devil.
Morning.
Grandma.
Morning, dear. Eggs and bacon?
Oh, no, thanks.
Tea? Coffee?
Yeah, coffee, thanks, Grandma.
Oh, no, I'll get it. Al, you've got a big day ahead of you, haven't you?
Yeah.
Being best man at a wedding's big responsibility. Now, where is that coffee?
Leave it, Jim. I'll do it.
Oh, thanks, Mum. Oh, that'll be the phone. No, don't worry. I'll go.
He's really enjoying himself, isn't he?
He certainly is.
Hello, Jim Robinson.
Hi, Mr. Robinson. It's Des.
Des! How are you, my dear old chap, on this bright and very auspicious morning?
Is Paul up yet?
Is he up? He's having breakfast. Why don't you leap the fence and join us? We're having tripe and onions.
No, thanks.
Well, you've got to eat, you know. Man's got to eat before he gets married. You want to talk to Paul?
Yeah.
All right, sure. Paul!
It's for you.
Thanks.
Hi. Is your old man always that bright?
He's got a bit of a sadistic streak.
How are you?
Don't ask. Hey, listen, something's wrong.
What do you mean?
Lorraine just phoned up and she's coming over with her parents. They all want to talk to me.
What about?
Don't know. Is Julie said anything?
No, Julie stayed at Lorraine's, the bridesmaid thing, remember?
Oh, yeah. It's a bit strange, though. Lorraine coming over here.
Yeah, bad luck as well. Hang on a second, Des. Julie's just walked in the door now. Listen, it's Des. He said Lorraine and her parents are coming over to talk.
Hey, Paul. A car's just pulled up. It could be then. I'll just check. I'll call you back. See you, mate.
Julie?
What's going on?
Look, I don't want to talk about it.
What do you mean you don't want to talk about it? Des said Lorraine and her parents are coming over now.
They are. I came on ahead. Hi.
Yeah?
You don't remember me. I'm Daphne.
Daphne?
The stripper from last night.
Oh, yeah, I didn't recognise you.
With clothes on. Yeah, I know. Do you mind if I come in? I know exactly where it is. Right under here. If I hadn't left in such a hurry last night. Oh, that's funny. It's not there.
Why don't you just take the whole thing off?
It's gotta be there. That watch means everything to me.
Listen, I'm expecting some people, so just have a look around. I'm gonna start cleaning up the living room before they get here.
Oh, I can't believe this. There's that guy over there, my best mate, and the bridesmaid comes home and tells me she doesn't know why the wedding's off.
Why did Lorraine change her mind, Julie?
Last night, after her parents both got to bed, we started talking. About men and love and all those sort of things.
Go on.
Well, then about midnight, she woke me up to tell me she wasn't really sure if she loved Des. Oh, I mean, I told her not to be so stupid. She wouldn't be getting married today if she didn't love him.
Oh, and then what did you say?
Oh, now look, don't you go blaming me for this, Paul. All I said was with me, right? With me, it'd be love or nothing. Like it was with Mum and Dad.
And then what happened?
Then about 2 o'clock, she woke me up to tell me I was right. She was marrying Des for all the wrong reasons. And ever since, I haven't had a wink of sleep.
She's done it again.
Done what? What have I done?
You're always telling other people how to run their lives.
I am not. She asked me for my opinion, I gave it.
Is that all you said?
No. I mean, once she had decided the wedding was cancelled, the obvious thing to do is to reason with her, isn't it?
Oh, and give your opinion.
Oh, will you tell me, Paul, how do you reason with somebody without giving your opinion?
I'll tell you how you reason with somebody.
Everything I said I sincerely believe to be right, and there's death to consider, remember that.
Yes, there is poor old Des to consider.
Morning.
Hello, Des.
Hi.
Oh, no! What have you done to our home? Our furniture?
Oh, it'll be all right, Lorraine.
Perhaps this will help you realise you made the right decision this morning.
What's going on here?
Dear, no, Lorraine, you agreed I'd do the talking. Lorraine isn't going to marry you. I can't say I'm sorry. In fact, I'm delighted. For all our sakes.
Well, just hold on a minute.
Please, let me finish. This family's always been prepared to face up to things. That's why the three of us are here this morning.
Hey, look where I found it. Mr. Kingham.
Daphne. What are you doing here?
Neighbours. Everybody needs good neighbours. Just a friendly wave each morning helps to make a better day. Get to know each other. Next door is only a footstep away. Neighbors, everybody needs good neighbors with a little understanding. You can find the perfect blend. That's when God.